Ellis Beef Easter's Radio Air Check and Classic TV Channel.
Program, our friend Rush Limbaugh. Rush?
My friends, with talent on loan from God and hearing on loan from the House Ear Institute, it is I, Rush Limbaugh, once again able to enjoy the melodious, mellifluous tones of my own voice. The device implanted in my skull has given me a range of audibility rivaling that of a German shepherd. I'm telling you, with this new gizmo, I could hear a mouse pee on cotton. Although I must admit, I recently had an experience that made me want to check the warranty on the apparatus, because I actually thought I heard Barbara Walters say that Rosie O'Donnell is gay. Stop the presses! The doughy diva of dim-witted discourse is a dyke? Why, it can't be. What's next? Someone's going to tell us that Richard Simmons and Barry Manilow are homosexual? Rosie's outing was sanctioned by Ms. O'Donnell herself, and the revelation appears in her forthcoming autobiography, Find Me, which, by the way, given her girth, would not be that difficult a task. Yes, after years of fawning over her heartthrob, cutie patootie Tom Cruise, O'Donnell's finally decided to come out of the closet, coincidentally at a time when it could best put money in the bank. Exploitive, to be sure. I suppose if you're going to admit you're gay, you might as well do it when it will bring a payday. Despite the initial tabloid sensationalism, Rosie's sexual preference is not something one would consider newsworthy, and the confirmation that the weight gain might now best be attributed to the munching of the box lunch is a moot point. The real story here is the gloves-off, claws-drawn catfight between Barbara Walters and Diane Sawyer, and it's a brawl that Rosie herself might even enjoy, for network news bunny name-calling is indeed the stuff of which lesbian dreams are made. Apparently, Sawyer, the albino anchor of ABC's Good Morning America and Primetime Thursday, had an exclusive interview with Rosie to be aired March 14th, and taped said interview the same day Walters discussed Rosie's sexuality live on The View. Now, officially, both Diane and Barbara have denied there's a rift between them, but I fear they doth protesteth too much. Sawyer is apparently sporting a scratch on her cheek, and everyone knows there's no love lost between them, since they both competed over interviews with Yasser Arafat. Diane scooped Barbara on that one, and so now it was payback time. Sawyer got the exclusive with the beard-wearing Palestinian. Babs got the one with the beard-implementing lesbian. I can't fault the much classier, more professional Ms. Walters for wanting to bitch-slap the lipstick off Sawyer's pasty face. I only wish she'd thought to inform me of that event ahead of time, so I might have been able to witness it myself. You just don't get those kinds of vicarious thrills without a cable modem, monitor, and a credit card. You see, I, too, enjoy the voyeuristic pleasures of watching two women go at it. I find women sexually attractive. I also like sports and prefer to wear trousers. Gee, I wonder if I'm a lesbian. More after this.
But, Eddie, listen. Why did Life magazine decide to take pictures of you at this time?
Well, they heard that one of the studios has asked me to do my life story.
You?
What's the matter, Harry? Why are you so surprised? Well, look at him. You! Yes, me! After all, they took the life of Cole Porter and put it on a screen. They took the life of Al Jolson and put it on a screen. Don't you think they should take my life?
I'm in favor of it. I'm a silver morning.